good. Today's video is actually going to be a closet tour, which is why there's an echo right now. I am currently in my bathroom because my closet is in my bathroom. You guys have seen me film in my bathroom a few times, like when I do skincare videos and stuff like that. But basically, this is my bedroom door. That's my bedroom. That's how you get into my bathroom. And then this is my closet, and this is Danny's closet. Danny's closet is a freaking mess. It's bad. I try to help him, but I just wanna say excuse the lighting in this video. Excuse this whole video in general. This is not like your typical closet tour. This video is not gonna be like most closet tours you've seen. Actually, I don't know how many closet tours you've seen. I've only seen a few of them. And to be honest, I'm not super interested in them. And I actually never thought I was ever gonna film a video like this. They make me uncomfortable, one. Two, I don't wanna ever feel like I'm showing off or like I'm being braggy. Ew. But it has been extremely requested. I thought, okay, what's a way that I can do a closet tour but still have it kind of mean something? Have like a purpose to the video, not just, oh look, here's all my stuff. So I asked you guys a couple weeks ago if you wanted to see a closet tour slash things I can't seem to let go of, because I have so many things in my possession that I have trouble getting rid of. Things I've had for years and years and years, and to be honest, I won't ever get rid of them. Like, these specific things are with me till the end of time. But anyway, without further ado, step into my closet. Oh, I'm filming this video completely by myself, so the jump cuts might be a little strange. And it's not like I can be like, come inside, because this is on the tripod, so. This is my closet. This is my closet. I know the angle is really weird. I'm gonna get you up in here in a second, but this is pretty much my closet. If I bring you directly in front of me here, you can see a little bit better. This is my door here. And then I do have like a space behind here where I hang my clothes. It's just the door's in the way when I open it. But then like over here, it does go a little deep in here. So because the lighting in my closet is terrible, it's like this really gloomy yellow light. I have my ring light set up here, but as you can see, I'm not getting much light from this side. So I wanted my closet to have some sort of storage. I just went to the Container Store and they did everything for me. Like, I went in there with my measurements, and on a computer they helped me design what I wanted, like the color and everything. So if you're interested in something like this, just walk on into your local Container Store. I keep all of my sneakers right over here. I love Nike, that's like my favorite brand ever, but I also love Reebok. And I keep them color coordinated, sort of. And I just keep like my most used sneakers here. I freaking love these. I try not to wear these a ton because I'm a hot mess and I dirty all my shoes. And these are like white on the bottom and I don't want to dirty them. But I freaking love these, they're one of my favorites. And I also really, really love these. These are super fun with like skinny jeans. Love these shoes. And oh my gosh, look who came to join us. I keep a little bed here for Porter because every time I take a shower, since my closet is in my bathroom, Porter likes to hang out in the closet and sleep on his little bed. I do have a few designer bags, but they were mainly gifts, actually. This was a gift for my anniversary, and then I have another bag back there that ColourPOP gave me when I hit 1 million subscribers. It was super sweet. And then I just have a couple more purses there that are like luxury, and I don't like to touch them. The only one I ever use to go out is like this tiny little Chanel one, and that's because I like to like hide the Chanel logo on the inside of my body so it doesn't look like I'm holding a Chanel purse, because it makes me uncomfortable. I do have a couple more purses, but I keep them in here. Can you see? I have like two of these. They're supposed to be like two dirty hampers, like a his and hers, but Danny and I just both share this dirty hamper, and then I keep like miscellaneous things in here. So like, this is my little purse I got from Forever 21. I love this thing. I like take it to the beach, you know, I keep it in here. And then like other little purses and stuff like that. Oh my gosh, my Coca-Cola fanny pack that I just got. How cute is this? I love it. I'm really excited that fanny packs are back. And then over here, this is where I keep like all of my long items. Jumpsuits, dresses, really long cardigans. I live in these little cardigan things. I have 1,000 of them. Like, look at these. I'm obsessed.
I also still have my prom dress. It's super wrinkled, but I still have it.
And then I added this little feature while I was at the Container Store so I could look at myself. How spiffy is that? Huh? You didn't expect to see that. That's cool. See my full body, which is really, really exciting. Growing up, oh my god, the house I lived in for 18 years, my entire life, we didn't have a walk-in closet. We just had like a curtain that opened, and it was a bar, and that's it. That was my closet. And I never had a full body mirror until I moved out, and I never had a walk-in closet until I moved to Mississippi, and we moved into an apartment, and I was like, what the heck? You can walk in these things? It was really exciting. Which is why I love my closet so much. Honestly, I have, for me, I have like my dream closet. Like, this is my dream closet. I never thought I was gonna have a closet that had drawers with my jewelry in it. Like, this is pretty cool. So when I went to the Container Store, I designed that the first two drawers were gonna be like jewelry drawers. So I keep all of my jewelry in here, and it's so convenient. I have all my little rings set up here. I have like these little rows for my necklaces, my watches, my bracelets, like everything has a place, and it's so convenient. So one thing I tend to get attached to for some reason is jewelry. I actually wanna show you guys these earrings. These are like little fish earrings I got in Key West. I was like 12 years old when I bought these earrings. Well, when my dad bought these earrings. My dad is like a man of very few words. He was always like a more serious man growing up. So whenever I came to shopping or doing anything like fun like that for me, it was mainly me and my mom, you know? And I remember one time we were in Key West, it was like a family vacation, and we walked into this store and I was standing next to these earrings. They were like on a little twirly thing next to the cashier, and my dad like picked them up and he was like, hey, I kind of like these. I'm gonna get them for you. And I was like, okay. And I don't know, I just thought it was so funny that my dad picked out a pair of earrings because he had never done that. And I cherished the absolute shit out of these earrings. I wore them all the freaking time. And whenever I do these like purges of my stuff, and I do that all the time, and imagine how many times I've done that since I was 12 years old, where I just get rid of all the things I don't wear anymore. Even though I don't wear these anymore, I can never get rid of these. This stamps a moment in history for me. And if I wouldn't have kept these earrings, who knows if I would have remembered that day, if I would have remembered that moment, you know what I mean? So this is a memory to me. I love those things. I kind of feel the same way about these owl earrings. I bought these when I was a freshman in high school, and there was like a boy I had a crush on who used to always point out how stupid I looked with these earrings on. He would be like, why are you wearing owls? And I would wear them all the time, and he just didn't get it. Whenever I look at these earrings, and it just reminds me of fun times in high school, so I hang on to this crap too. These earrings were my sister's. I love these things. I don't know why. When I first saw these when I was younger, there was something about it that just called my name. I just remember looking at these earrings and loving them so much. So when my sister finally gave them to me, it was like the best day of my life. And honestly, they hurt so bad. They're clip-on earrings. I never freaking wear them, never wore them, but I love them. And I will never get rid of these earrings. And just the thought of these earrings actually makes me sad, because I had a ring that I've had since I was a little girl. It kind of looked like that in the sense where it was like clear and there was like a flower in it. It was yellow with a red flower in it, and it was just like this. And I used to wear it all the time. I loved it. It said made in Mexico on the bottom. It was like a nice like distressed ring. It was beautiful. And I lost that. I mean, I know I lose things all the time. You guys know this, but I don't know how I lost that. I've had that for years. I've been trying to look everywhere for that freaking ring, and it is nowhere to be found. To be continued, I'll let you guys know. This ring, however, is also an extremely special one. This was my mom's, and she actually got this ring when she was in high school. And she used to wear it all the time, and I just remember loving it. And I remember also thinking, like, is that a sun or is that a sunflower? I never really knew. Now in my adult age, I would say that's a sun. So when she gave it to me, it was also a really special moment. And I actually wear it all the time. I try not to wear it that much because I'm scared to lose it, but I love this ring. I want to tell you guys about this guy right here. It's the weirdest story ever, honestly. It's very strange, but I had a friend in high school, and one day I text him like, oh my gosh, my mom just cut my hair. It's so short. It's a lot shorter than I thought it was gonna be. I look hideous. Oh my gosh. I was like venting to him on the through text like, oh my gosh, I look terrible with short hair. And he was like, okay, meet me in the morning. I need to see this haircut. I need to see what you look like. And he told me to meet him in front of wood shop. So while I was walking to wood shop, I saw this like little ring sitting outside of the door, and it just said hope all over it. It was just like this little weird metal thing that just said hope, hope, hope. And it was just sitting there. It wasn't tied to anything. Nothing else was around it. And I know it's seems like dumb and dramatic, but I was very dumb and dramatic in high school. But I took that as a sign, as in like, girl, get over it. It's just hair, you know? So I picked up the little metal thing and I put it in my pocket. And while I was in first period, I took off my shoelace and I tied it to this thing, and I put it around my neck, and I wore it as a necklace, and then it became my everyday necklace for the entire year. I'm pretty sure I was a sophomore when I made this. This was my necklace, like, every day. Boom. Hope. I never got rid of it. I just felt like I was meant to find this little ring. Dude, I don't know how to explain it. I can't describe the feeling. It was just a feeling. Another thing that, oddly enough, I can't seem to get rid of is this weird fish. My sister used to wear this all the time when she was in high school, like her senior year or something. And I was that little sister who like really wanted to be just like her big sister growing up. And I used to love this thing. Every time she would wear it, I would just stare at it. I used to think it was the coolest freaking little fish necklace. And when she got rid of it, I was like, I'll take it. I love that thing. And I don't know, I've kept it ever since. I gotta get a chain for it because I lost the chain, but I love this little thing. I don't know. And then the rest of these are a mess, I'm not gonna lie. Like, this is like my sock underwear drawer. Oh my God, so bad, I can't believe I showed you that. I keep my workout clothes here. I haven't worked out in like months, but whatever. I keep my jeans in here. They're a mess. I'm a little messy when it comes to drawers, I'm not gonna lie. I keep some of my perfumes here because I do get dressed here a lot, and whenever I'm like on the go and I'm in a rush and I can't run to my beauty room to put on my perfume, I just pick one of these. Gucci by Gucci being an OG queen. Up here I just keep like crop tops and stuff, shorter shirts, you know, so they don't disturb my perfumes. And then I have two shelves on each side of this thing where I keep all of my shoes. So they have these little doors on them so that your shoes don't get dusty. Danny made sure that this feature was added. Watch this. Beautiful. I slam things. I have a problem with shutting drawers a little too hard and breaking drawers sometimes. So thank you, Danny, for that one. I really appreciate it. And then on this side of the door, I just have like some more room to hang things. Here's where I keep like all of my sweaters. I have all of these plaid shirts and I have... This is all sweaters. You know, it's like, how do you have so many sweaters? You live in Miami. Honestly, I don't know. And then down here, I keep some more sweaters. These are mainly just like jackets though. I have all my denim jackets. This one is really, really cool. I love this one. This is the denim jacket that the stylist gave me at the KLPolish fall photo shoot. And then on this side of the door, I keep like my jerseys over here. My basketball jerseys, like my baseball jerseys, whenever we go to games and stuff. And then I keep like nicer blouses here as well. And then I also keep skirts over here, like pencil skirts or shorter skirts that don't make it to that side of the closet. But yeah, that's it. That's pretty much it. That's my closet. This is where the magic happens. I keep the majority of what I wear on a daily basis in here. I'm a t-shirt girl, if you haven't noticed. Oh, by the way, I am the world's worst folder. It's really bad. But you know, I keep all my t-shirts here. Just like all my t-shirts. All the t-shirts you guys ever see me wear, this is where I keep them. Classic, this one. Classic. Even the back, look at that. Why am I bringing it here, you ask? Well, I have a few t-shirts I can't seem to let go of. This is the first sweater I ever bought with my own money. That's insane. And yes, I bought like a million other things with this too, but this is the item I held on to. This shirt honestly is just a pure example of my slight OCD. Honestly, whenever I would do my yearly declutters where I would go through all my stuff, I would never get rid of this. I bought this as a sophomore in high school. I remember the day I bought this and everything. I would never get rid of this shirt for some reason. It's a very comfortable shirt, I'm not gonna lie. But it got to a point where I wasn't wearing this anymore, but I wasn't getting rid of it because it had been too long. Do you know what I mean? Like in the back of my mind, I thought, oh my gosh, maybe there's a reason I'm hanging on to this shirt. Like, am I subconsciously hanging on to this for something? And I felt if I got rid of it, something bad was gonna happen. It's a really weird thing. But I feel like if I don't hang on to this shirt for the rest of my life, the world might explode. Just saying. Can't explain it, but it is what it is. There are two shirts I hang on to because of Danny. This one, because he bought this for me years ago, like when we first got married. And he said it described me perfectly. I loved this. I used to wear it to bed all the time. It was like my favorite little pajama. And yeah, the fact that he walked into a Charlotte Russe and bought this blows my mind every time. This one is a weird one. So I wore this shirt the first time Danny and I ever hung out. Well, I've known Danny since I was like 12 years old, kind of like from a distance, because he's Amelia's stepbrother. But the first time we ever like hung out on a date, kind of like a date. Not really, like a day, I was wearing this shirt. I was wearing this with like little black, not little black shorts, but like regular black shorts. And I remember he was like, oh my gosh, I like your shirt. And I was like, thanks. And it was so weird because there's nothing special about this shirt, but turns out these are the only three colors that Danny wears, like his entire wardrobe. Actually, if you throw red in there, then that would complete everything. Black, red, blue, and white. The only colors Danny wears. So that would explain it. But I was like, oh my gosh, thanks. And I don't know, I've kept it ever since. I can't get rid of this. This was like the day date shirt, you know what I mean? I saved the best for last though. This is my favorite tank top to ever exist, ever. I have worn this so many times and it's still going so freaking strong. And this is from Forever 21 from like 1,000 years ago. And it's still going strong. And there are a couple little things. But I mean, this was my sister's when she was in high school. That's how long this has been around. I'm actually gonna pop up a picture right here where my sister is wearing it and we're actually in my old room. And she's like a junior or a senior in high school and she's wearing this tank top. I graduated high school in 2010 and she's 7 years older than me. But I love this. I cannot get rid of it for some reason. It just has so much history to it. This thing can go through a hurricane. I will never let you go. We will be together forever. That completes this video. I hope you enjoyed this closet tour slash things I can't seem to get rid of or slash things I have a weird emotional connection to, except that one gray and white shirt that means absolutely nothing to me, but it's with me till the end. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was at least entertaining. I hope it was something for someone. That completes this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.